Hey guys, Nick here today, and welcome back to another episode of Minecraft Survival on the MapleCraft server. Now, here is progress, ladies and gentlemen. Progress, I say. Look at it! It's, beautiful! Oh my god, look at all the grass and the torches and the chickens! Oh, so beautiful. I've been working, doing stuff, and I've lost some footage. I did do, like, little progress updates in various episodes, but... long story short, my microphone, wasn't recording and I lost it all, and then, I fixed that issue, but then I didn't plug in my microphone before launching my recording software, so when I recorded, a collab video with Chris the other day, I also didn't get that. So, this is me right now telling you that you should go over to Chris's channel, because him and I did some, he's great and you should go over there anyway, but him and I did some, stuff. Firstly, he invited me to, help out, well, I offered my help, for his Capture the Flag minigame, and then we also pranked, Torch, so you could go over, either to Torch's channel or to Chris's channel and check out, what the prank was. Chris has us building it, and Torch is his reaction to the prank. So, you know, you could check him out, check both of them out, and that would be cool. Yes, so that was very fun, very cool. Sadly, I lost the footage, but, not to worry, you know, Chris still has it, and Torch has his reaction footage and things like that. But I did do other collaborations, and, so next episode is going to be, a combination of all of those. I just took all the bits. It was with kit and armor, and then just with armor, two clips. And yeah, so there you go. Those are for next episode. That's what that's going to be. But this is just going to be sort of a progress update. What's been going on in the server the past week and a half or so since I was able to last update you. So yes, personally here, I have this. My next step is to build a little base here and sort of decorate this, remove all the walls and replace it with hardened clay, or to make it look more like a cave. One of the two. I'm not sure which, because on one hand I could replace this all with blue, light blue, probably, stained clay, and then, you know, put clouds and stuff and trees and make it look like a nature reserve, an indoor nature reserve type thing, or, even though there's a house in it, I guess just an indoor slice of life, or I can just make it look like a house in a cave and, you know, blow up the areas and make it look like more like a cave. Either way is perfectly acceptable. If you know have ideas, let me know in the comments below. I will read through them. But for now, I'm just gonna sort of roll with the punches, see what works out. I'm gonna build this and then design the outside later. So yeah, that's the general idea. Anyway, moving on. Like I said, Torch was pranked, but he is such a quick cleaner upper. He came on like pretty much immediately after Chris and I built this, and then took it down, and when I came back on the server, like, 3 hours later, bam, it was gone, and I was like, whoa! So yeah, here's the only remnants from that, and, yeah, so go check out those videos. Moving on, as you can see in the distance, there's the second statue, and I don't know if the first statue has been shown yet, but there's Tidy Designs. In full color, first statue. It looks really nice. Kit made it. I think he's made in Kit. Tidy and James as like a memorial type thing, since both of them, the original founders, have left the server. And now, also other sad news. Shelby has also left the server, but she, she's really busy with life and stuff. I'm sure she's making a goodbye video or something, so maybe you could check that out. If not, she's leaving mostly for, you know, she hasn't had time to come on and record and really play, so she doesn't want to, take up a spot on the server or something along those lines. But yeah, there's Tidy. As you can see, a thing on his finger. I'll talk about that in just a second. It's a poster, and I'll talk about the posters in a moment. So yeah, Shelby has left, and you might notice that a lot of people are really leaving these days, and... MapleCraft is shrinking right now, but it's just going through, you know, shrinking pains, I guess. It's going through change. It's certainly not going to keep shrinking. In fact, we have two people who we're looking at right now, and they may or may not get in. You'll just have to keep watching and keep following MapleCraft to figure that out. So, you know, we're sort of shaving off all of the, I don't want to say fat, because that's a negative connotation, but we're shrinking down so that we can grow back up again. It's like how when you're working out and, you know, to develop muscles, you have to first, like, tear your current muscles, and then they, you know, get stronger and rebuild and things, and or however the heck that stuff works. The point is, though, you know, sometimes you gotta go backwards to continue forwards. And don't worry about MapleCraft. I think, personally, that it will always be around. Now, I'm not the one paying for the server or anything, but I mean, if you ignore that aspect of it, I think it will always be around, because even if it shrinks down to just four people, it's just going to get tighter and more close-knit, and is going to be more, you know, it's going to be easier for those people to just collab easily with each other and to be even closer. You know, they don't have to worry about, oh, someone might want to build here or something, you know, things like that, because it's easier to communicate and stuff like that. So I think it'll be more close-knit, but I don't think it'll ever stop, because it's a group of friends, and we're all just on here to have a fun time and you know, do good by each other. So, yeah, and then over here in server news, this is the White Mamba. The White Mamba watches, or so says the poster that is also on Tidy's finger. And these are around, and the reason this is around is because the Black Adder has returned. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, the Black Adder, who was originally on Codex Season 1 as an evil mastermind, a prankster of all sorts, has returned onto MapleCraft. We don't know if it's the original Blackadder has come back, or if it's a copycat prankster, but the Blackadder has returned, and it seems with him, he has brought the White Mamba. You know, are they rivals? Are they teammates? I genuinely don't know. These are questions I'm asking. but I hope we find out in the coming weeks, or at least before season 3 of MapleCraft ends. It's exciting stuff, and I can't wait to see how that develops. But Noir Time Detective Agency, PI. So Armor has started his own detective agency, his private investigation firm. And so he is going to be investigating all this, all that's going on with the White Mamba and the Black Adder. So make sure to follow his channel and go look at his for, you know, the most recent and, you know, the most speculation, the most factual, I guess, and evidence provided, probably the most, you know, it's to see all of that, the most accurate view on the whole thing. Go ahead and check out Armor, if for no other reason than to see the amazing cinematography with which he is doing for these episodes. He recently made a really cool episode, and it was well made, and I loved it a lot. And it was about the Black Adder and the White Mamba and stuff. It wasn't about the White Mamba, because that wasn't a thing yet. But it was about the Black Adder, and he was going around asking questions and stuff. Also, another news right here. So this, Chris and I sort of did this. We were placing cobble. I don't even remember why, but we placed some cobble, dug around a little bit, and placed these signs. But then somebody, I don't know who, but somebody came on by. They dug this out even more, and then they hid some villagers back here. And I'm thinking it's Kit, because right there, that's where the statues are. And it's not, like, underneath a statue or anything, but it's right next to it. So I'm sure Kit would have noticed or something, and maybe he would have been the one to build it. I'm assuming that Putzy had some villagers or something in his base, so Kit was transporting them out. But as you can see, this right here leads to that. As you can see, I was just over there. I don't know what's going on there. I don't know if that's just to contain the villagers for now while they're moved to a separate location, or if that's their new location, or if that's some sort of secret prank type thing going on there. Not 100% sure, but the point is, it's a thing. And I think that's about all that's been going on the server recently. Chili and Cranky also came back on. I don't know how long it's been since they've been on, but I haven't seen them around, so it was cool to see them once more again. And unfortunately, I didn't really get to talk with them or collaborate with them, any of that stuff, because, like, right when Chili came on, I played for a few minutes, but then I went and ate lunch, and I came back, and he was gone, and the same thing with Cranky with dinner, and that was both on the same day. So it was like, weird. It was like, oh my god, everybody's coming back today. So it was exciting. Yes, of course. Get out of here, there's a zombie you with your golden armor. You think you're so rich? You think you're better than me? You fool? I got a sword. I shank you, man. I steal your gold. Anyway, so yeah, that's basically the going-ons of the server the past few days. This is meant to just be sort of a progress update. I'm not really going to do much in this episode. Much else, because this is it. So yeah, thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed that little wrap-up. I know it wasn't long and we didn't really do much, but it's just getting you guys caught up on the comings and goings of the server, because it is an active community that's changing a lot, and it's exciting to, you know, sort of stay in touch with all of that. And yeah, so that is it. Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And stay tuned!